Hello, today I'd like to visit with you about fishing for king salmon out of Monterey Bay. Typically, what they're going to be using there is going to be a slip sinker, about a 24-inch leader, and you're going to use this over the side of the boat. And basically, the people will be lined up along the side. They will throw out some chum. Out there, what they do is they pull in over a school of fish. They'll throw the anchor, and then you'll stop, and the captain will tell you to start fishing. And they're pretty specific as to what they tell you, and they don't want you to change the drag setting on the reels. They'll be using drags and reels like this, big bait casters, but you won't be casting them out. What they do is have you put your bait on, hold it over the side of the boat, and you will do pulls. And they will tell you to do 18 or 20 pulls. And depending on the depth that the fish are, and if you do a full arm length pull, that's going to be about 30 inches, and they will put you right down in the fish. You count out that 18 or 20, and within a few seconds you're going to have a fish on. So they've got it down real well. And what it does is it keeps the bait from coming back up the line and climbing the line and getting all wound up around itself, because the bait fish that they use are going to cause this to spiral in the water, and they don't want it hung up on the line above the sinker when it gets down there. And by doing this, it's a very gradual, easy presentation. I caught four of them in about 15 minutes. And what they do is the captain will tell you, once you start catching fish, nobody stops until the limit is caught. And so actually, I ended up catching two other people's fish. But for the boat, what he's afraid of is that they're going to lose the school. And so they get in on top of them. You just start in fishing, and it's kind of the luck of the draw as to whether you get to catch all your own fish or not. But every one of them were cookie cutter, 12, 13 pounds. We were just on the went up probably about an hour run north of Monterey, up along the toward the north end of the bay, and just did real well. And one thing on these reels that I wanted to show you, they're not gonna be level winds. You notice that there's no level wind in here. And there's a reason for that, because on these party boats, they can get some pretty rough treatment. Short rods, lots of activity, big fish coming in over the side. And this is a old pin 60 reel. And just very durable. And I'm not advertising them by any means, but I've had this forever. What you need to do with them, and it's not going to be a problem when you're only going out 18, 20 pulls, but anytime you would use one of these, you have to watch how your line is piled on there, because you want it to be fairly even. A little bit of dome here in the middle doesn't hurt a thing, but you don't want a whole bunch piled up one side or the other, to where it can fall over on itself. Could cause a bird's nest and cause a problem. But this line, it's just going to run in between these two bars, and then it's up to you to make sure that it travels back and forth as you bring it in, so it's piled up decent on there. So it doesn't take much. Once you get used to it, it's pretty easy. The on the side here, got the release and the lock mechanism. So back here it's in the locking mode. And there it's released, so we can let out line. It's got a clicker on it here, where you can do away with that clicker. But there's a lot of times that, because it's going to be completely silent right now, and there's a lot of times when you want that clicker on for fishing different kinds of fish. And if you're trolling, you want that for an indicator also. And I hope that this helps you, and hope you can go out on a charter sometime and have a good time fishing.